Now I'm going to talk about only the Spearman rank correlation. There I'm going to highlight when we can use this one, how we can be find out the Spearman rank correlation answers, then which are the condition we can adopt this kind of Spearman correlation. That things I'm going to be emphasis now. Yes, the first slide for you, the Spearman rank correlations. Actually, it's a non-parametric statistics, but if you look on the Pearson product movement correlation, the last class we discussed there, that is commented the parametric, but it is called non-parametric. The Spearman is non-parametric, but Pearson product movement correlation is a parameters we are getting now. Now this also the same, what is the need to find out the Spearman rank correlation? In the sense, it is to use to study the strength of association between the two ranking variable or two ranked variable. Here also we may easily find out the two important things as well, the direction of the relationship as well as the strength. So the magnitude is represent the strength, the positive and negative symbols denote the direction of the relationship. The same kind of Pearson here also we are using, but only the thing here, the two variables should be in a ranking format. What is the ranking? In the sense, it should be ordinal data. So it should be ordinal data. If both the variables are ordinal in nature, we can go with this kind of Spearman rank correlations. Because we already know there's a four kind of scales of measurement other. One is called nominal, ordinal, interval or ratio. If the both the variables, independent variable and dependent variable, or in a interval ratio format, we can go with the kind of parametric statistics known as the Pearson product movement correlation. But if the variable is coming to categorical, particularly in the ordinal format, order based or ranking format, we have used only the Spearman rank correlation. This is a main thing. Even the net examination, the questions may come. If both the variables are ordinal in nature, what correlation we have to be adopted? So that answer for this question is only the Spearman rank correlation. This method is applied to the ordinal set of numbers, which can be arranged in order one after the other so that the ranks can be given to each. For example, even if you have the continuous data like height and weight, that variable may be a continuous nature. Then if you convert in a categorical format, like in an ordinal format, in a ranking position, we can able to adopt this kind of Spearman correlation. Without changing in the ranking format or ordinal format, you cannot be able to do a Spearman rank correlations. I hope you understand. Spearman rank, or the term itself, the rank describes, it means that the correlation, we can adopt only the two variables in a ordinal format or a ranking format, then only we can adopt it. This was developed by Charles Spearman, but the Pearson product movement correlation developed by the Pearson. This is called as a Spearman rank correlation. Actually, there they're using the word R. So the Pearson, we are using the word R, but here we are using the term, say, rho. So I already mentioned that rho is for the small sample. If you go with R, is for the large sample. The correlation for large sample, we may use the term R. For small sample, we use the term rho. It's nothing but sample population like that they are categorizing. Therefore, this symbol act for the parametric statistics. The rho symbol is act for the non-parametric statistics. So I hope you may get it. This for parametric, this for the non-parametric. It assesses how well the relation between the two variables can be described using a monotonic function. This term is important. The last class in the Pearson product movement correlation, we are talking about the linear function. So there is called as a linear. What is the difference between linear as well as the monotonic? There is a small difference between the linear and monotonic. That things I'm going to highlight now. Before that, just I'm going to highlight the particular contributors, none other than Edward Spearman, that small small biography. He was born in 10th September 1863. He was born London, United Kingdom. Died in 17th September 1945. That died in the same London, the age of 82. He made a lot of contribution, not only the statistics, even the psychology also, because he's the man, he founded the two-factor theory, like G factor, then S factor, specific factor, and all. Then in the statistics, he did a tremendous contributions. Particularly, he made this rank correlation coefficients, factor analysis. These are his contribution in the statistical area. Apparently, he contributed in the psychology also. So it means that he's a great psychologist as well as a great statistician. The notable students are for his notable students are the follower, Cattell, John C. Raven, as well the David Wexler. These three people are the followers of him. Then he influence is nothing but the some of the teachers he mold him, or he may follow that kind of teachers. So he followed the Francis Galton as well as the William Wunder. He is influenced by these two peoples. Now I'm moving to my task. What is my monotonic relationship? What is my monotonic? The last class we are talking about the linear. Linear means it's called linear. So the straight line form is called linear. But sometimes the linear may become as a monotonic. But normally the linear means even the distribution may comes like this. A lot of dots may comes like this. Okay, the dots may come this, but if we are focusing this linear, the straight line only, that equation only we are founding. So that based on the strength, based on the linear only we are getting the that scores, whether it may be positive or negative. But in this exam, it's a positive, perfect positive. But in the monotonic, see here, there is a scatter. The diagram may be scattered, not in exactly it's a linear. So a somewhat curve shape is come, little curve, not any exact curve, so a light curve. So it may be positive, and it's a positive, purely it's a positive, but the curve shape is not a straight line. See here, normally the linear means it comes like this. Linear shows like this, but it's not a linear. It means that one variables increase, other variables also increase. It's called as a positive correlation, but not in the same ratio. Same ratio. If it increase the same ratio or constant ratio, then it's called linear. If you not increase in the constant ratio, then it's called as a monotonic. So this is called non-monotonic. It may be curvilinear. So these are things. If the curve is comes like this, we could not be we could not do it. We could not be able to do a rank correlation. We could not be able to do a rank correlations. This also non-monotonic. But sometimes the monotonic may comes this kind of complex also. So see here, may goes like a straight line, not in perfect straight line, somewhat curve shape, little curve shape is there. So when the curve is comes like this, in the data distributor, like in a monotonic format only, we have to adopt this kind of rank correlation. The last class, we are talking about the linear. Linear means the straight line. See this case, so I am drawing this diagram. So this is a monotonic, but whether it's a positive or negative correlation, it's a negative correlation. But if you go with the linear, it may apt for the linear as well as the, I can go with another color. See here, the red color mark, I make it as a red color. Yeah, I'm going to the another color mark of the pen. Yeah, I'm coming to do a graph. So because it may comes like small, because that scores is comes like this, no, it's not be scattered around the straight line. It must somewhat to be distributed happen. That's why there is a chance the green color line may comes like this. It means it's a monotonic. Sometimes the linear may be a monotonic. Linear correlation may be a monotonic. But in this case, if I draw a straight line, it's not possible because the scores are distributed like this. Therefore, normally the curve may comes like this. But it like a positive correlation, but in a small monotonic base. It means that the scores are distributed not in a or in a scattered, not in a some perfect ratios based, it won't be distributed. So therefore, when we can use this kind of rank correlation, the scores may be, the distribution may be in a monotonic, then when we can adopt the linear, what is rank correlation. But if it is linear nature, we can go with non-parametric statistics, that is none other than the Pearson product moment correlation. But we could not be use the non-monotonic things for the rank correlation. So if it, the distributions comes, we could not be use this one. We can go for curvilinear and all. This is a basic introduction about the monotonic relationship. Why the Pearson correlation assess the linear relationship, but the Spearman correlations access the monotonic. There's a two difference I'm handling. This also may comes to the NET exam. Pearson correlation access the linear relationship, but the Spearman correlation access the monotonic. This is the two difference are there. And it may be positive or the negative. Normally the monotonic positive relationship, monotonic inverse relationship. So we are using a positive linear, perfect linear, perfect negative linear. Like that we are talking about the in the Pearson powder Bowman correlation. The same thing we can use in a different way here. Yeah, this is called negative normally, but in the monotonic we call it a monotonic inverse relationship. It's nothing but a negative relationship. This is called as a monotonic positive relationship because it's still a positive correlation. We can use the term monotonic positive relationship. Like that, we can be differentiate between the two linear as well the monotonic. Now I'm giving the examples of other monotonic also. See here, if the line is come straight only, it's called linear, but it's not a linear, it's come somewhat curvilinear, little, not in much, but the scores may be distributed like this. So the scores may distributed. So I'm putting the scores like this. So these are the dots is called a scores. The scores may distribute. That's why the curve is comes like this. The distributions, I'm drawing one curve, that curve is may comes like this. So it's like a positive correlation that is called monotonically increasing. It's nothing but a positive correlation. If it comes in negative, normally the negative correlations in the linear, it may comes straight, it may comes like straight. But in this case, in the monotonic, the scores may lies like this in the curve, little curve manner, but the scores may distribute. I dot put the dots. Based on the distribution, I am making one, that's like an average base, I'm drawing one curve, that may lies here. It is called monotonically decreasing, is nothing but negative correlations. We could not be used this kind of rank correlation for the non-monotonic. So we could not be adopt this one. Normally the terms we are telling monotonically increasing means if x is increase, this is called, I already mentioned it's a positive. What is the meaning of positive? If x is increase, y also increase, not never decrease. That's why they, instead of increasing, they put never decreases. So monotonic increase means x variable increase, default y variable should be increased, never be decreases. The monotonically decreasing means negative correlation. If x is increase, y should be decrease. Otherwise, x is decrease, y should be increased. So here, y variable never be increased. It means that both are not same. So they put this in reverse order. Don't confuse with this. Non-monotonic, as x is a variable and y is a variable, sometimes decrease and sometimes decrease. Like some kind of fluctuation may be there. This kind of thing we cannot be do for attempt for the rank correlation. Yes, I move to the next one. In the figure below, various samples and the corresponding samples correlation coefficient values are presented. The first three represent the extreme monotonic correlation. See here, this is called monotonic. I already mentioned this curve is like a monotonic. It comes in like a monotonic base is coming. It's like a monotonic, but it comes in negative. So we already know it's called negative. It's called negative correlation. But it may vary strengthen. It's like a very positive strength. Like when we talk about the linear, we are talking the perfect positive. No, if the curves, the distribution, see here, all the distribution, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There is a 8 scores. The 8 scores lies exactly the particular line itself, the particular curve itself. Therefore, it's called perfect positive monotonic correlation. It's nothing but a negative. But it's a perfect negative. That's why they're using the word perfect negative. But it is called zero correlation. This we already knows that. So when we comes to zero correlation, we cannot do this kind of correlations. This is called perfect positive. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The 9 scores or 9 variables may lies in this area in the same curve itself. Therefore, it's called as a perfect positive. It's called as a monotonic positive correlation. So this way, but in the linear, it becomes a straight line, but it's not a straight line. That's only the difference between the linear correlation as well as the monotonic correlations. Now, the next thing in this graph is talking about the negative only, but not in a perfect. It comes here very strong. It comes -9.4 something. Because see here, if the scores, if the data slice, if it comes like this and all the scores, for example, I'm taking another color, the Greek color, all the points, all the scores may lies in the exactly the same of the curve, then it's called perfect negative. But in this case, some of the scores are deviated from the curve. Therefore, it's called very strong, but in negative. This case, it's called positive, but some of the scatters, see here, the scores are scattered around the line. Therefore, it may be positive, but not in a very strong. Therefore, it's come as a weak positive, the scores may come 0.372. These are some of the examples I quoted here to understand the meaning of monotonic and linear. Those are understanding the difference between the linear and monotonic, kindly type the chat box UUU. So it means that you are understanding well. The U represent, you understand well the difference between the linear as well as the monotonic. Linear means it should be a straight line. Monotonic is not a straight line, but somewhat little curve based maybe the, that is called monotonic. Now, if you want, I will emphasize the another example also. In this case, one variables increase and other variables increase. One variables decrease and other variables also decreases. It vice versa also may be possible. But there is a difference between the monotonic as well as the linear. This term is important. It, in the same direction, it may increase or decrease, or it may one increase, one may decrease. But not always the same rate. This is a term is important. This is a term is important. But in the linear variable, the same like positive correlation, negative correlations, but there is a chance the same rate of increment or decreasing may happen. So here the term not always same rate. Here the same direction at the same rate may happen. Therefore, this way the two things to be differ. Monotonic, the same kind of positive negative is there, but not in the same rate may differ. But in the linear, it may increase. If you increase one variable, other variables increase called positive, but in the same rate. If you go with the negative, one variables increase, other variables will decrease, but in the some kind of same rate may be there. Then it's called linear. I hope you understand. All are able to understand, no? Please, I request all to type in the chat box. Those who understand the difference between the monotonic as well as the linear. Yes, now I move to the next level. So my voice is audible to all of you? Yes, thank you, Saranya. So it seems they understand. So I'm talking about the two things. One is called linear. Last class, we are discussing about linear only, but there is a small difference between linear and monotonic. That's I'm talking here. Normally, this is called a negative correlation, according to us, the linear based. But sometimes the linear may be a monotonic. See here, because like a straight line comes, but it is negative. Therefore, we are using the term monotonic inverse relationship. Instead of using a negative, they are using the term monotonic inverse relationship. Otherwise, we can use the term negative correlations. The monotonic direct relationship is nothing but a positive correlation. See here, it's like a curve based. It's positive because x is increased, y also increase. X is decreased, y may be decreased. That is called positive. So sometimes the linear may be a monotonic, but all the monotonic may not be a linear. That's you had to tell. You had to understand. So linear, it may be come as a monotonic sometimes. Okay, but so linear sometimes may come as monotonic, but all the monotonic may not be come as a linear. So some cases may be different. Yes, now I move to the next slide. Yeah, this is a formula I'm going to talk about now. How to do the rank correlation. Very simple correlation compared to the previous Pearson product moment correlation. Here I already mentioned that the symbol of rank correlations row. It's called non-parametric statistics, and also the row represents the sample only, small sample only, we can use this term. The formula 1 minus, the 1 is common to all. So 1 minus, then this is a bracket. So this is the whole thing comes as a bracket. So what is the formula? 6 summation b squared divided by n into n squared minus 1. So this is a formula. Some people are using a row, then RS. RS means the correlation of sample. They are using the term correlation of sample. I already mentioned that the sample, we are using the term row. For the population, we are using the, using the symbol as a R. So now this is a formula. 1 minus 6 summation d squared. Some people are using a small letter, some people are using a capital letter. Each textbook having different. But the d represents the difference between the two ranks. Difference of two ranks. The d represents difference of two ranks. Then n represents number of observations. It's nothing but number of people's number of observation. That is called n. So here n, n square. Normally n represents a capital N represents the population. Small n represents a sample. So that's why in the formula, we are they are using this term n. They are using the term small n. When you go for the Pearson, see the, I'm going to the Pearson, the formula, they are using the term capital N. I hope you understand. Because we are checking with the population now, therefore it's called as a parametric statistics. So even we are doing sample only, but the findings may act for the sample, that may be adapt for the population also. But this kind of statistics, rank correlation may act only for the lowest sample, low sample only, as well as the non-parametric. It means that the variable should be in a what is the format, ordinal form. Now I'm going to do a sums now. This is for the general formula. Some cases, some ranks may be, for example, the same values comes twice or thrice. If it comes twice or thrice, you can go with a different formula, but it's not needed because if you found this one also, it's apt, but no need to go with a separate formula. Even the rank is to be repeated, or the same score is repeated, or the course is not repeated, you can add the same formula. It's not a big problem. But the correct method, if the rank is repeated, we can use this one. But the most of the statisticians not use the as it is. So they are using always these formulas only. But properly, we can use the separate formula if the ranks are repeated. It seems that the same values comes. For example, I had some students in my class. Three or four students got the same scores. The particular examination, then we can be use this formula instead of this formula, instead of we can use this formula instead of the first formula. Here M represent the number of repetition of rank, so M1 M2, so the second rank, third rank, based on this may differ. Now I move to this sum. This is sum. They provide the scores of two subjects, English and mathematics. This formula we know, okay, D represent the rank difference between the two rank, so two group of scores. There is an English, therefore I am going to find RE. So RE represent rank of English. So they're like that rank of mathematics. So RM, I am putting it wrong. RM. The D is nothing but the difference between the RE minus RM is called D. So the people, some people using capital D. I am using capital D now. That RM. So it's nothing but RM. Sorry, RE minus RM. So this is a formula of D. So RE minus RM. That score, they put it like this, 56, 75, 45. There is a mark of the English students. There's a mark of the mathematics students. So one student got 56 mark in the English. The same student got 66 mark in the mathematics. Like that, the two groups. So here, the each column represent a sample, each individual. So 71 one students got English, the same students got 60 mark. 60 students one got in the classroom, the same student got 65. Like that equally, each row represent the each individual only. For finding the rank is very simple. Now the English, mathematics, there's a two scores are that. Now I'm going to find out the rank of X or rank of English. For this, I'm going to select another color to look on this. I'm selecting this color, yes. See here, in these 56, 75, 45, 71, 62, which is the highest number, like a descending order, we are giving the rank in a descending order. The biggest scores or the highest score, we can give the first rank. The lowest score, we can give the last rank. So in this score, the highest mark is 80 of the English mark. Therefore, I am giving the 80 as a rank one in the English mark. Then what is the second mark in this case? Please, I request the people to give the answer in the chat box. What is the second mark? What is the second mark in this particular column? Second mark is 76. Very good. Surya is correct. Okay. Therefore, I am giving the second rank here. Second rank here. If it comes the third rank, so which is the third rank? So in this case, 75 is the third rank. Therefore, they're given as a third rank 75. Now, which is the fourth? Then it is called fourth rank. It goes to 71. Therefore, I am ascending as a fourth rank for this 71. Which is in fifth rank? So it's like ascending order. So descending order. So after 71, which is the lowest number? In this case, 64. Therefore, I am ascending as a fifth mark. Then the next after 64, 62 is the lowest. Therefore, I am ascending as a sixth rank. So then after 62, which is the lowest mark? 61. Therefore, I am ascending as a seventh rank. Then after 61, what is the lowest? It's called 58. Therefore, I am ascending as the eighth rank. Then 56 is the lowest next. Therefore, I am ascending as the ninth rank in this example. The lowest score is 45. Therefore, I am ascending as the 10th rank. So it means that there is a 10 scores. Therefore, how many ranks should be there? There's a 10 scores and there's a 10 rank may be there. So in this case, there's no remutation. There is no repetition of this course. There is no repetition of the rank. So there's no issue. Now I'm going to the, I'm selecting the another color to marking with this one. I'm selecting the another color. Yes, I'm selecting with green color to mark this one, mathematics. So in this mathematics, the highest score is 77. The highest score is 77. Therefore, in the rank of M or rank of Y, I can use as a rank 1. I request the students give the answer in the chat box. People are giving. It's like an interaction only. Now the second mark is goes to the mathematics. Therefore, I'm giving 70. I'm giving the second mark. Then which is the third mark in this case, the third lowest. So in this case, the third lowest goes to 67. So I'm giving the third mark. Thank you, Surya, to remind me. Then next, after 67, it goes to 64. So 64, the fourth mark. Then next, what is the next one? 64, then fifth one may come 65. Yeah, so I'm giving this as fifth. After 65, it comes 63. Therefore, I'm assigning this a sixth rank. Then after 66, it comes to 63, it comes to, yeah, 760. Very good, Prasanna. So it's seventh rank. Then after 60, the lowest mark is, yeah, 59. Therefore, I am assigning it's eighth. Then eighth, then after this, 56 is called ninth. I fix as a ninth rank. Then which is lowest score is 40. I am assigning as a tenth score. I am assigning as a tenth. So like that, I am assigning the rank of the each marks, rank of X, rank of Y. So in this formula, the six value is common, this like constant value. We need the D value, but they given a D square only. Therefore, we have to find D. After this, D square. So D is represent RE minus RM, otherwise rank of X minus rank of Y. In this case, 6 minus 4, 5. So I'm selecting the another color to mark it easily. Yeah, I'm selecting this color, yes. So 6 minus 4 is equal to 5. Then 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. 4 minus 7 equal to minus 3. So this is called equal, I'm writing. Then 6 minus 5 equal to 1. 5 minus 9 is equal to minus 4. Then 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. Then 1 minus 1 equal to 0. 2 minus 3 is equal to minus 1. Then 1 minus 6 is equal to 1. So now I found the D. But according to the formula, we need a D square. Therefore, I'm finding the D square. So 5 square 25, 1 square 1, 0 square 0, minus 3 into minus 3 is plus 9. Then 1 square 1, 4 square 16, 0 square 0, 0 square 0, minus 1 square, minus into minus plus, that we know. Then this also minus 1. Then we need the summation. What is the summation represent? Addition. Addition of all the addition of the that D square value. Therefore, I am adding the 25 plus 1 plus 0. So I am adding all plus. Okay, 25 plus 1 plus 0 plus 9 plus 1 plus 16 plus 0 plus 0 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to, finally we got the scores as a 54. So the addition is called 54. The person is correct. So the 54 is coming. Then finally what I did, rho equal to 1 minus 6 summation d square. We already know the value of 54. We have found that 54 I am writing. Then n, why is called n is called a 10? Number of scores, number of variables. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I write the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this 5, sorry, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a number of samples, number of samples. So in this case, n equal to 10. Therefore, 10 into 10 square minus 1. Therefore, 10 square. We have to finish, we have to do the first calculation this side. So we know the Bodmer's rule. So we have to be finished this part, then finally we can be minus from the 1. Okay, so now this part 1 minus 324 divided by 990 is equal to 1 minus 0.33. If you less from the 1, we may get the score is called rho is equal to 0.67. Is it a positive correlation or negative correlation? The question for you, is it a positive correlation or a negative correlation? Is it a positive or yeah, exactly, it's a positive. But whether it's a high positive or average positive or a moderate or a very high correlation. So in this case, me positive, but the scores is near to the 0.7 or the above 6. It means that some kind of moderate level. Okay, the moderate level of correlations. So it comes there. We can use the things is maybe positive, moderate, otherwise moderate positive correlation. But it's day monotonic. Now, the same example, I'm coming with my Excel, because the Excel, we may easily to grasp the meaning and other thing. Just I'm coming back to the Excel sheets. There you may perceive the exact meaning of the correlation. I'm doing the same thing with here, but I'm going to give some repetitions. See here, there is a, instead of English and mathematics, I'm going with mathematics and science. So I'm going with the first mathematics, then I'm going with the science here. So as an example, so now I'm going with ranking of, this is for rank of max, rank of max, this is for rank of science. So I have the two groups, there's a 10 students only I'm using. Science, yes. So now the D and D square, D is nothing but rank of X minus rank of Y. Just I'm deleting this one, I'm deleting this one. Now the questions for someone's, so now I request anyone that question, I'm giving the platform, sorry. I'm giving the time for Surya, kindly give the mark for mathematics. You can give some random basis, you can give the mark. Surya, kindly unmute your end. Yes, talk to me. You can tell the 10 numbers, yes, please. Give the 10 number.
So it's range, how much is
it? It can go with nearly 6200, 6299. 6299.
Okay, first one, 65.
Sorry, wait a minute. 65, yes.
72.
You can give some repetition of this course also, some repetition.
Okay. 67.
Okay.
72.
84, 89, 65, 75, 80, 92. Thank you. So, okay, now the Saranya is there. Sufaya.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sarne is there. Okay, Sarne, give the science mark. Any
75, 82.
Okay.
79.
84. 79.
65. 65, very good.
Four more numbers. Hello. Yeah, I'm audible. You are audible. So four more numbers.
72.
Some repetitions. Okay, I will put, so two more scores I put. So like 79, sorry. Then I am putting 82 also. Thank you, Saranya.
Okay, thank you.
So now just I'm making a say one more column insert. Okay, so there's a name or a serial number. So I'm putting the serial number or a name. So I'm putting the name in the name of ABCD. Okay. This for A student, this for B student, this for the C student. Like that, I have the 10 students. Okay. So I'm putting the, so I'm going with the two students. Probably ABCD. Yes, I'm going D, E, F, G, H. Then I, then J. So these are the student's name. Instead of typing the student's name, I'm making a CL numbers only, sir, like letters only I'm quoted here. So what it means, the A student, for example, Albert getting the max mark 65, the science mark 75. The Banu, she got the 72 in the mathematics, the same student got 82. So I hope all of you having the idea about this one. Just I'm going to the rank of max, okay. For this, I'm going to do a correlation now. So I'm going to do a correlation, rank correlation. Why, that question for you, why we have to be change the continuous, this is like a continuous data. Why we have to sift the continuous data into a ranking data? Is it need for an is it need for doing a rank correlation? Please, anyone can give the answer. Actually, here we already have the continuous data like interval or ratio. But why we need to be convert as a rank mode? Rank mode. What is the need? What is the need? Anyone? Give the answer in the chat box. Otherwise, you can unmute and then talk to me. So, what is the need? We have to be sift the continuous data into ordinal data. What is the need? Anyone? Yes. So I will tell you, because in this case we are using a Pearson product moment correlation. The main assumption to do a Pearson product correlation is the variable should be in a ordinal format, but we have the interval or ratio format continuous data. Therefore, we have to sift once in a ordinal, then only we are able to apply a rank correlation. Suppose they asking generally correlation value, no need to be. If they specify only rank correlation, you can convert. If they not specified any kind of correlation, you have the variables already in a continuous data. Therefore, you can go directly with the Pearson product moment correlation. If the questions comes the Spearman rank correlation, damn sure you should be convert the continuous data into a rank. Then only you are able to do a correlation. Otherwise, you could not do it. Now the Surya, so you are only telling this course. Kindly unmute in Orion and you can tell the rank of this particular mathematics mark. How we can assign the rank here? So you are giving the mark like 65, 72, 67. So which is the highest mark in this case, Surya?
92, sir.
92. Therefore, we are assigning one. The number one. Very good. So number one. Very good. The first rank over. What is the second rank?
Then 89.
89 is the second rank. Very good. So I am putting the second rank. What about third rank?
Third rank, 84.
Yeah. So the third rank, I am giving is 84. Then fifth rank, fourth rank?
That is 80.
So yeah. So the fourth rank is 80. The next rank, fifth rank?
75.
Yeah. This is the fifth rank. Very good. Fifth rank. What is the sixth rank?
72, there is two,
yeah.
72, sir.
Yeah, so see here, in this case, five ranks lower. Therefore, we have the two scores, the same score. What is the score? So normally we can give six and seven. Give six and seven only. But in this case, both the scores are same. Therefore, what you have to do, we have the two ranks should be merging. What are the rank? We are merging with the sixth rank plus seventh rank. Therefore, I'm typing here. Sixth rank plus seventh rank. So it comes twice. The scores comes twice only, the same score. Therefore, divided by two. So what you have to do, we can take an average of the score. So I am taking the, I am adding the two ranks. What is the rank? Sixth plus seventh rank divided by the two. If the three scores comes same score, you can divide by the three. But here only two scores are comes. And the sixth and seventh rank can be divided into two people. So you got the sixth rank and seventh rank divided by two people. Therefore, I am adding 6 plus 2 divided by 2 is called. So what is the answer? Sorry, I'm putting the equal. So if we put equal, we may get the answer 6.5. So now I'm going to be assigning the 6.5 in the both the groups. 6.5 as well as 6.5 in the both the schools. You got clear?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, 7 ranks over, because we are taking the 6th and 7th rank and the average only we are typing here. Therefore, 7 ranks over. What is the 8th rank? Which is an 8th rank in this case?
67.
Yeah. So now this is an 8th rank. So what is the 9th rank?
65 and 65. So
normally the 9th and 10th rank is divided by the two people. Is it got okay? So yes, therefore 9 plus 10 divided by 2. What it comes? 9.5. So this 9.5 you have to allot it for both the groups. You got clear?
Yes, yes sir.
9.5. So this way, this is called average. We have to divide the average ranking to the each people. Right? But in the class, normal classroom, for example, if the two students are getting the same first mark, when they go for the ranking, they will remove the second rank. They will tell the first rank 2%, then third rank only. You got clear? There is no second position. Yes, if the two persons are getting a secured the same mark as the first score, there is no second rank, they will go the third rank only. They remove the third rank. But in this case of statistics, we can be merge the first and second rank and we can take it only the average. Now I'm going to the rank of science. So now I request Anushree. Anushree. Anushree, kindly unmute. And Anushree, yes. Okay.
Yes,
now you
sir.
Can hear the Anushree. Just I'm doing one more modification. Actually, here only the two score. Any repetition here? This 72. There is
82.
No repetition. Yeah, 79 twice is coming. I'm adding. Three times 79 is coming. Very good, very good. So okay, now it's a turn for Anushree. Kindly tell in the science rank which is your first mark. Which is the first rank we had allotted?
84.
Very good. What is the second rank?
82.
Yeah, but the 82, how many times it comes? How many times
2.5.
Very good. Exactly. So, Anushree, you are so great. Then,
can
we give the 80. Third rank or fourth rank next? Huh? Can we give the fourth rank? Okay. Fourth rank, no? So, I'm
yes,
giving the fourth
sir.
Rank. So, I'm giving the fourth rank for whom? Which mark we 80. Can give the fourth rank? 80, yeah?
80.
Yes. 80, yeah, where is 80? Yeah, so the fourth mark. Then, which is the fifth mark?
79.
Very good. But 5. The problem 5. Is, yeah, so what are the ranks you should be dividing? No, no. Kindly see, 79, how many times is coming?
2 times.
No, no. Kindly no. check how many times.
Okay.
3 times. 3 times are there. Therefore,
okay.
We have want to yeah, we want to be as seen as 3 ranks. What are the ranks? 5th rank, 6th rank, plus 7th rank. Okay. So I am adding the 3 ranks divided by how many numbers? Divided by
3.
Yeah, very good. Because the 3 people are dividing the scores. Therefore, I am dividing the 3 is equal to 6. Therefore, I can assign the scores of 79 for 3 people. The rank is here 666. You got clear, Anushree?
Yes.
Now I have 666. Whether can we go with the 7th rank or 8th rank? Can we go with the 7th rank or 8th rank?
8th rank.
Very good, correct. Because 7th rank is already over. Because we are taking the average of 5th rank, 6th rank, 7th rank. Therefore, there is no 7th rank. We can move to the 8th rank only. What is the 8th rank in this case? Which is an 8th rank? Which is an 8th rank? 75. Very good. 8th rank. Okay, I'm giving say 80. Then which is the 9th?
72.
Yes, it's the 9th. Very good. Which is the 10th?
65.
Very good. Now it's over. So now I got the 2 ranks. Now I got the 2 ranks. Thank you, Anushree. Kindly mute. Next, Arya. Arya, kindly unmute. Kindly unmute and talk to me. Arya.
Yes.
Now, what is the next step we have to do, Arya? What is the next step we have to do?
Find the D.
So, what we have to do?
Find the D.
Very good. So, we have to do the D. So, how we can do the D? So, here, Rx, rank of max minus rank of x minus. So, yeah, 1 minute. So, Adira is coming. Yeah. So, here, we are going to R. So, what is the rank of max minus rank of sines? So 1.5 for the second case. What is the second case? I'm just doing the formula. 6.5 minus 2.5, 4. 8 minus 6, 2. 6.5 minus 1, 5.5. 3 minus 6 minus 3, 2 minus 10 minus 8, 9.5 minus 4, 5.5, 5 minus 9 minus 4, 4 minus 6 minus 2, 1 minus 2.5, 1.5 minus 1.5. Yeah, so next question, Sapphire, kindly unmute. Kindly unmute and talk to me. Yes, Sapphire, what is the next? What we have to do next? What do you have to do next?
Find the square of D.
Very good. So in this Excel, we can go with F2 into F2. So there is a formula if you are applying F2 into F2. So I'm doing. So is equal to F2, then into, once again, F2. It's nothing but square. So we may get 2.5. This is 2.5. I'm adding. So in down, we may get these summation value. The summation is nothing but is equal to sum of, I'm making as a formula through Excel. Sum of this entire score and making and to enter. So the score is 178. Automatically they made the formula. So that's why it's coming. The formula is 1 minus 6 summation d square divided by n into n square minus 1. In this case, see here the formula 6 minus g12 is nothing but 178 divided by n 10 into 10 square minus 199. If you multiply the answer, it may comes the score minus 0.7. 0.078. It means what? Anyone can tell what is it a positive correlation or negative correlation? Please kindly give the answer in the chat box. Is it a positive correlation or negative? In the negative, what it means is a negative, damn sure is negative. Is it a high positive, high negative, or a moderate level or low negative correlation? Very weak, exactly. Shashwati, correct. Very low, otherwise weak correlation. We can use the term very, very low. Instead of low, we can use the term very low because it's very near to the zero. It means that there is no much correlation relationship between the two score. It means that there is no relationship between the mathematics mark and science mark of each individual. It means because the scores are not that much of equally made it because they put in random ways, you know, that's why it comes like this. Suppose if you change modification, for example, parallel, I'm adding for each score 10-10 mark, we see what it happened. Then automatically the scores may change. Then it comes, if X is increased, Y also increase, come the positive. If X is increased, Y is decreased, then it's called negative. That's we already know. But I'm not doing the other attempts. Very simple way I'm explaining here. I hope you may understand what is the meaning of the rank correlation. Just I'm going to be summarized with these things. What is the merits as well as the demerits of rank correlation? Okay, the merits of the correlation. Rank correlation is very simple to calculate compared to the Pearson, because Pearson we need to calculate it, do it. But here it's very simple way we can do it, because VC to minus, VC to multiply, not that much a problematic calculation here we are doing. It's very simple to understand compared to the previous one. The positive points here it can be applied for any type of data, even the qualitative test or the quantitative. Hence, a correlation with the quantitative data. Sometimes we can do the qualitative convert in a small ranking base, then we can do this kind of correlations. This is most suitable in case there are only two attributes. It means only two variables we can use this kind of correlation. Therefore, this is some of the merits I'm highlighting. Apparently, there is a weak also, there is a negative and a demerit also there. One is called, it is only an appropriate calculate to measure as actual values or not used for calculation. See, in this case, they already given the score 56, 75. But what we are doing, we are not taking the raw score for doing a calculation. We are converting this entire raw score in a ranking format, then only we are doing. So it means that we are not able to take the same score as it is for doing a calculation. That is only the negative. Then the loss sample is not the convenient method. I already mentioned it's non-parametric. It means that the sample size is very low. Then only we can use it. So for the loss sample, we could not adopt this method. Combined or of different series cannot be obtained as the case of mean and standard deviation. So if you are converting the scores, continuous data in a categorical, we could not be used for the mean and standard deviation. So mean and standard deviation is meant for the parametric studies. Here, we could not be used for the mean and standard deviation once you convert as an ordinal scale. It cannot be treated further algebraically. So it means that we cannot be do for further calculation with this kind of statistics. So once you finish, after that, there's no further calculation. But if you go with Pearson product moment correlation after the regression, then after the regression, it moves to the path analysis. Like that, there's a sequence order there. But in the rank correlation and all, once you finish the rank correlation further, we cannot do that next level. So that's why somewhat limitations are there. I hope you understand the meaning of Spearman rank correlations and its features and its merits as well as the demerits. Now in this class, I emphasize the how to do your calculations. What is that advantage, disadvantage? So when, in which case we can use this Spearman rank correlation and all. I hope it may be very useful for you. So we meet in the next occasion.